Hello students, our topic is molecular basis of inheritance, and in today's lecture we are going to discuss the gene regulation and the expression. So next point is the regulation of gene expression. We have completed in previous lecture the protein synthesis part up to the translation, and in last lecture we have seen that this translation process includes the initiation, elongation and the termination step that we have completed by the figure. And now we are discussing the new point from this topic, that is the regulation of the gene expression. Before that, we should know the gene and how it get expressed. So everyone is know that what is mean by gene, but that point again I am going to revise here. That is, gene is nothing but it is a part of DNA, because if you know the gene very well, then and then only you can understand the regulation of the gene expression. So this is the DNA fragment, and some part of the DNA is called as a gene. Suppose it is a part of the DNA, then we call it as a gene. Okay, so gene is nothing but it is a part of the DNA. And as we know that while discussing the structure of the chromosome, we also discussed that chromosomes are the carrier of the genes, because these chromosomes which are present in the nucleus of the cell, this chromosome always carries the genes on it. So gene is a term which is nothing but it is a part of the DNA, or we may call it as a, it is present on the chromosome, and these chromosomes are present in a cell, in a nucleus. So here we have to discuss, that is the regulation of the gene expression, how this gene get expressed, get produce or sorry get function in our cell, that is called as a gene expression. Now here we will discuss the first, the functions of the gene. That means no doubt gene is a part of DNA, the genes are present on the chromosome, but what is the function of this gene? The gene has various types of function. One important function of the gene is that it is a unit of heredity. It is a unit of heredity. That means every time we see that the genes are transferred from parent to their offspring. Genes are transferred from parent to the offsprings or parent to their children. That is called as the unit of heredity. And due to which the genes are present from parents get transferred to the children. The children look like somewhat similar to their parents because of their genes. Okay, so we call it as a unit of the heredity. It is one of the important function of this gene. Second function of this gene is that these genes are involved in the important mechanism of our body, and that we call as a protein synthesis. That is protein synthesis. The second function we have seen very well during the process of transcription and translation, because you know that for the process of transcription there will be formation of the mRNA, and that mRNA will be produced by the DNA molecule, and DNA is nothing but the, it is a gene. Okay, then by the mRNA there will be formation of different types of the proteins, and those proteins which are formed in our body are indirectly produced by this gene. So second function, that is the protein synthesis, is nothing but the function of the gene, and it involves transcription and translation process during the formation of protein synthesis that we have already discussed in this translation and the transcription process. So these are the some of the important functions of the genes which are carried out in the cell of every living organisms. Okay, now here we have to see that how the activity of this gene get regulated, how the genes get regulated in a cell at a different time. First, you should know the meaning of regulation of gene expression. Regulation of gene expression means the activity of the gene in a body sometimes get on and sometimes get off. That is called as a regulation of the gene expression. Again, I am discussing the same point. Regulation of gene expression means the activity of a gene in a cell sometimes get on and sometimes get off. That means sometimes in a cell gene get expressed, sometimes gene get cannot get expressed, or sometime gene can function, sometime they cannot function. That means the activity sometimes switch on and sometimes switch off depending upon the surrounding condition, depending upon the need of the organism. Not all time genes are always expressing in our body. They are always switch on, but sometimes they always switch off because there is no necessity of the activity of that gene, and that is called as a regulation of gene expression. Simple तुम्हाला मराठी मध्ये म्हणून सांगायचं झालं तर काय सांगते आपल्याला, हे जीन जे आपल्या बॉडी मध्ये असतात हे जीन कधी ऑन असतात, ते ऑन असले की त्यांचं एक्सप्रेशन दाखवतात, त्यांच्यापासून वेगवेगळे प्रोडक्ट तयार होतात, ते त्याचे वेगवेगळे फंक्शन कॅरी करतात. कधी जेव्हा जीन ऑन असतात तेव्हा, आणि हे जीन जेव्हा ऑफ असतात तेव्हा त्यांच्या ह्या ऍक्टिव्हिटी ज्या आहेत त्या स्टॉप होतात, त्या ऍक्टिव्हिटी बॉडीमध्ये पाहायला मिळत नाहीत. जसं लाईटचं बटन आपण ऑन केल्यानंतर लाईट सुरू होणार आहे, ऑफ केल्यानंतर लाईट बंद होणार आहे, तसं जीनची ऍक्टिव्हिटी ऑन झाली की जीनचे जे काही फंक्शन्स आहेत बॉडीमध्ये ते आपल्या बॉडीमध्ये चालू राहणार आहेत. पण तो जीन जर आपण ऑफ केला किंवा तो जीन जर ऑफ झाला तर त्याचे जे काही फंक्शन्स आहेत त्या सेलमध्ये ते आपल्याला बंद असलेले पाहायला मिळणार आहेत. दॅट इज नथिंग बट द रेग्युलेशन ऑफ द जीन एक्सप्रेशन. दॅट इज नथिंग बट द रेग्युलेशन ऑफ द जीन एक्सप्रेशन. नाऊ वील डिस्कस द फर्स्ट टू लास्ट पॉईंट विच इज गिवन इन अवर टेक्स्ट बुक अबाउट दिस रेग्युलेशन ऑफ द जीन एक्सप्रेशन. नाऊ हिअर वी हॅव टू सी दॅट हाऊ दिस जीन गेट रेग्युलेटेड. सी हिअर वॉट इज मीन बाय जीन, दिस इम्पॉर्टंट फंक्शन वी हॅव सीन. नाऊ वील स्टडी दॅट how this gene is regulated and its product is synthesized. Every gene, see here, every gene is get regulated and then its product is synthesized. That means for the product of the gene, which are the products of gene? Proteins formation is the product of gene, or the gene which passed from one generation to the next generation from parent to offspring is the product of the gene. So first that gene should be regulated, and after that there will be product is synthesized. If there is no need of the product, that gene get switch off. If there is a need of the product, then that gene get switch on. This is called as the regulation of the gene. Okay, and after regulation you will find the product from that particular gene is synthesized. Okay, that gene is synthesized. That means when gene is on, product is synthesized. When gene is off, product is not synthesized. So gene should be regulated according to the need of the body, and then only if there is necessity then product is synthesized. If there is not necessity, product is not synthesized. So it is the first point that gene's activities are regulated and gene they form the product or synthesize its product. So how we can see that gene get expressed? How we can say that gene get expressed? Gene expression is nothing but the protein synthesis, or we may say that polypeptide chain formation. What is meaning? Okay, so we say that gene is expressed. How it is expressed? When there is a formation of the polypeptide chain takes place in a cell, then that we call as there will be protein formed, because polypeptide chain later on form the protein. So if the polypeptide chain is formed in a cell, we say that that gene is expressed. So when gene form its product, then we say that gene is expressed. So gene expression, in one line you can understand that when there is a polypeptide chain formation takes place, then we say that gene can get expressed. Okay, that gene can get expressed. Now here we have to see that this expression of the gene can be regulated at various level in a cell. So for this again we are taking the example of the polypeptide chain synthesis or the protein synthesis. How the gene activity is regulated at various level in our body, that we are going to study now. So what is mean by regulation of the gene at the various level? That means if we want to stop the expression of a gene. If we want to stop the expression of gene, for example, if we want to stop the expression of the gene to the polypeptide chain, or if we stop the polypeptide chain synthesis, we have to stop the protein synthesis. Now what we can do? If we stop the protein synthesis, then what we can do? We have to regulate that gene at a different level. There are various chances to regulate that gene at various steps during the transcription. So here we are going to study that in eukaryotic cell. In eukaryotic cell, there are various level. At that level, we can regulate the gene activity. We can stop the gene activity and we can prevent that gene from the formation of the polypeptide chain. So gene regulation can be carried out at various level in the eukaryotic cell, and first at the level of the transcription. So first level is called as the transcriptional level. That means during the formation of primary transcript, that is during the formation of primary transcript, that means what? Here say that you are well known about the term transcription. Formation of the mRNA from the DNA we call as a transcription. So if anybody want to regulate the activity of gene, he can stop that gene activity at the transcriptional level during the formation of the primary transcript. Primary transcript means what? The RNA which is formed from the DNA is called as the primary transcript. The RNA which is formed from the DNA is called as the primary transcript. And when these primary transcripts are formed in the transcription, we can stop the activity of the gene. So that what happens? This primary transcript do not undergo further processes. It do not undergo the splicing process. It do not undergo the formation of protein, that is called as the translation process. So here we can stop the activity of the gene. So next steps of the transcription will not be forming that cell. Second one is that we can also stop the gene activity at the processing level. At the processing level, that means where the processing level is takes place? During the regulation of the splicing. During the regulation of splicing. So what is mean by regulation of splicing? That we have also seen in the processing of mRNA. That means in eukaryotic cell, we have seen that mRNA should be processed under both capping, splicing and tailing. Splicing means removal of the intron part from the mRNA. So at this point also, you can regulate the gene activity. You can stop that gene from the further steps. That means splicing steps is when carried out, you can stop that gene, and that gene will not go to the further steps. So here also we can stop the activity of gene during the processing of the mRNA. Third step, we can also stop the protein synthesis at the level when that mRNA transfer from nucleus to the cytoplasm. Third step is when mRNA goes from nucleus to cytoplasm, because everyone is know that this mRNA are formed on the DNA. So DNA is present in nucleus, so mRNA is first stage at present in the nucleus, and from the nucleus that mRNA then goes towards the cytoplasm, towards the ribosome which is present in the cytoplasm. So if you can stop the mRNA from going to the nucleus to the cytoplasm, or if we prevent this mRNA to cytoplasm, then you will stop the protein synthesis. mRNA will not go to the cytoplasm. You will not give message to the ribosome, and ribosomes are not involved in the process of protein synthesis. And at last, we can stop this protein synthesis or the polypeptide chain synthesis at the translation level. Translation level. So these are the four mechanisms. These are the four mechanisms by which you can stop the activity or regulation of the genes. Here you can see that it is very important point that at which step genes can be regulated. So these genes can be regulated at these four steps. first one is called as a transcriptional level, while there is a formation of primary transcript. Processing level, when we regulate the splicing step. mRNA goes from nucleus to cytoplasm at that point, so you can regulate or stop the activity of the gene. Or at translation level, that means all these three processes are completed in that cell with the help of gene, and now you have to stop the protein synthesis. Then you cannot allow it to complete a translation process. Then only you can also regulate the gene activity. That means that gene will not produce the protein. He has already completed these three steps, but last step he will not complete, and we can regulate the gene at this various level in the eukaryotic cell. So it is a best example, that is how we can regulate the activity of the gene at the transcriptional level, at the translation level in a cell, in particularly eukaryotic organism. Now the next example of this regulation of the gene expression is that these genes which are present in a cell are expressed to perform different functions. Okay, these genes in a cell are expressed to perform the different function. What is that? That means here, for example, if we take the E. coli is a Escherichia coli. It is a type of bacteria in which there will be a formation of an enzyme. The name of that enzyme is called as beta-galactosidase. This is the enzyme which is produced in this E. coli cell. So you know that enzymes are the proteins. So it is a protein, or it is a enzymes, we are supposed to say that it is the protein. So beta-galactosidase enzyme is produced in the E. coli. Why this beta-galactosidase is important in the E. coli cell? Because this beta-galactosidase enzyme is essential for the hydrolysis of the lactose sugar. Hydrolysis of the lactose. Because when beta-galactosidase enzyme is there, it will break down this lactose into the glucose and galactose. Lactose will be break down into glucose and galactose. So, for a breakdown of the lactose sugar into glucose and galactose, there will be necessity of the enzyme beta-galactosidase. So, what we have seen, that the genes in a cell are expressed for a particular function. So, here the gene in a E. coli cell is expressed in the form of formation of the enzyme beta-galactosidase. And that beta-galactosidase enzyme later on break down this lactose sugar into glucose and galactose. So it is an example that how the gene in a cell can express. So this gene of beta-galactosidase is expressed in a E. coli. He expresses and he immediately break down the lactose sugar into glucose and galactose. It is an example of gene expression in a cell. Okay. So next point is that there you will find that this gene get expressed at a different time in a different cell, and you will see that not every time this gene is expressed, because gene expression depends on the metabolical, the physiological or the environmental condition. How it is that we are going to study, that is how the metabolic, physiological or environmental condition regulate the expression of gene. So it is very important point that metabolic or physiological or environmental factor regulate this metabolic, physiological or environmental factor regulate expression of gene. How it is that we are going to take discuss with the help of same example, that is the E. coli. So what happens? Generally, for every living organism, glucose is a substrate as a source of energy. From primitive to the well-developed organism, glucose is a source of energy. Every living organism use that glucose as a source of energy and carry out their different activity with the help of energy released from that glucose. So in this E. coli bacteria also, there is not lactose available as a source of energy. There is always glucose available for this bacteria as a source of energy. So as there is a no lactose, as there is a no lactose in their surrounding, lactose is not there in their surrounding to this E. coli bacteria, then how that beta galactosidase will be synthesized? Because the role of beta galactosidase is that it hydrolyze or it break down this lactose sugar into the glucose and galactose. But already this E. coli bacteria do not have any lactose in their surrounding, so there will be no formation of beta galactosidase. Because while no formation of beta galactosidase, because this beta galactosidase is not required there, because there is no presence of this lactose sugar. When lactose will be there, beta galactosidase will be developed. When lactose is not there, beta galactosidase will not be developed here. So as beta galactosidase is not developed, means there is no lactose in the surrounding. So the activity of gene, that means beta galactosidase is an enzyme, is a protein which is developed by a gene. Okay, so here the activity of this gene in that E. coli cell get regulated because there is no lactose. So that activity of the gene is switch on in that E. coli cell, because that gene will not form the beta galactosidase enzyme or beta galactosidase protein, because there is no necessity, because the substrate which is required for that beta galactosidase is not there. The substrate is a lactose, and here there is no lactose substrate. Instead of that, there is a glucose substrate. So here that we call as a metabolic, physiological or the environmental regulation of expression of gene. Means what? The metabolic process of the E. coli do not require lactose, it requires glucose. Okay, so lactose is absent, gene can be switched off, gene can be regulated, and it do not produce the beta galactosidase. Okay, like that. It is also physiological condition, because the all activities which are taking place inside our body, we call it as a physiological activity. So physiological activity of E. coli, or the metabolic activity of E. coli, or the surrounding nature of the E. coli, means the environmental condition of the E. coli, decide that which gene is on and which gene is off. So in this process, the gene for beta galactosidase is not on, it gets off, because there is no requirement of this beta galactosidase. Instead of that, gene for lactose will on, and it produces the further enzyme for the degradation of, here the gene for the lactose will be off, because there is no necessity of the beta galactosidase, because no lactose is there. Instead of that, gene for glucose is on, and the enzyme which is essential for the breakdown of the glucose will be produced by that gene, and their activity will be continued. So it is very, very important that how the metabolic, physiological and environmental condition regulate the expression of a particular gene, the expression of a particular gene. Okay, so it is a best example. Another example is that the here you will find that there are development of the embryo and differentiation of the embryo. That means after the formation of zygote, there will be formation of the embryo. Okay, and that embryo get differentiate, means there is number of processes takes place in that embryo, and that embryo become converted into an adult one. So second example is that development and differentiation of the embryo, development and differentiation of embryo is also one of the another activity of a gene, because this embryo get developed and it get differentiated, and that is also under the control of a gene expression. So there are number of examples in our body which can be under the expression of the gene, but here the two examples are given. One example is from the bacteria E. coli, and another example is given that is how the development of embryo takes place in the living organism, and that embryo get differentiated and gets converted into the adult one under the activity of a gene, because all the stages of the development of the embryo are controlled by the gene. So it is again the activity of the gene expression. So here you will find that there are different factors which regulate the activity of gene, which are responsible for switching on or switching off the activity of gene. Here we have seen the example of the beta galactosidase, how that beta galactosidase gene switch off because the lactose is not there. Okay, so this is about the regulation of the gene expression. Now the next point is that the example is there how or what mechanism will be there in E. coli, because number of experiments of the genetics did on this E. coli. So again we see the example of this E. coli. Okay, what is by adaptation in E. coli? So this E. coli adapt to their chemical environment. This E. coli adapt to their chemical environment. To their chemical environment. How? By chemical environment, their adaptation by synthesizing certain enzymes. Adapt to their chemical environment. Adapt to their chemical environment by synthesizing certain enzymes. According depends on substrate. Okay, these adaptive enzymes are called as inducible enzymes. These adaptive enzymes are called as inducible enzymes. Okay, and the substrate is called as inducer. Okay, now what is that? See here, E. coli, Escherichia coli bacteria adapt or adjust to their environment. Environment that is called as chemical environment. Why it is called as chemical environment? Because in the surrounding of this E. coli, there are different chemicals are present, and that chemical environment of that E. coli decides that E. coli to adapt to synthesize certain enzymes depending on the substrate. Substrate means what? That here just we have taken the example that if E. coli has a two source of energy, one is glucose and another one is a lactose. Okay, majority in E. coli there is a glucose present, and according to this glucose that E. coli synthesize different enzyme for the breakdown of glucose. Okay, if glucose is not available, then there will be availability of the lactose to this E. coli, then the gene for the lactose will switch on and there will be breakdown of that lactose sugar. Okay, so that chemical environment means which substrate is present in the surrounding of that E. coli decides the E. coli to synthesize the enzyme. If glucose is there, E. coli synthesize enzyme for the breakdown of glucose. If lactose is there, E. coli decide or form the enzyme for breakdown of the lactose. So E. coli adapt to their environment. And how this adapt? According to the presence of substrate. Substrates means either glucose or the lactose. Substrate means either glucose or lactose. So which substrate is present around it, which substrate is present around their chemical environment, decide the E. coli, or according to that substrate, that E. coli adjust karto to environment. Adapt means adjust. According to that E. coli adapt and form the different enzymes. So it is the nothing but the response given by organism to their environment, and according to which that organism regulate its gene expression. Here what happened? This E. coli has given a response to their chemical environment, has given the response, the substrate which is present in their chemical environment, and according to which he can regulate its gene expression. If in the chemical environment substrate is glucose there, then he can form the genes for the glucose breakdown. If the lactose is there, then E. coli form the genes for the lactose breakdown. So it is nothing but the response given by organism to their surrounding and according to which that organism regulates its gene expression. Okay, again one other point is that the enzyme which are produced according to the adaptation of the E. coli, these enzymes are called as inducible enzymes. These enzymes are called as inducible enzyme. What is meant by inducible enzyme? The enzymes which are produced according to the need of substrate. According to the need of substrate. If glucose is there, enzyme for glucose will be produced. If lactose will be there, enzyme for lactose will be produced. And those enzymes are called as inducible enzymes. These enzymes are only produced according to need of substrate. And enzymes are the inducible enzyme. And the substrate according to which those enzymes are produced by the E. coli, that substrate, whether it is a glucose or the lactose, that substrate is called as an inducer. So you should know the term inducible enzyme, inducer. Inducer is nothing but the substrate present in the environment of E. coli, because here we have taken the example of the E. coli and here we are going to discuss same E. coli for the regulation of the gene expression. And that's why you should know that E. coli bacteria's enzymes are called as inducible enzyme, because they are produced according to the need of substrate and the substrate is called as the inducer. Number of times there will be question asked that what is inducer. So inducer may be glucose or may be the lactose. Okay. So here we will discuss that how this induction is occur and what is meant by induction. If you are known about the term inducer, then what is mean by inducible enzyme, then we'll see what is mean by the induction. So next point is that induction means what? A set of genes will be switched when there is necessity to metabolize a new substrate. When there is necessity to metabolize a new substrate, it is called induction. Okay, and this is nothing but the positive control. It is nothing but the positive control. So see here, a set of genes will be switched when there is a necessity to metabolize a new substrate. It is called as induction. Because see here, if the lactose will be available to E. coli, then that E. coli produce the enzyme for the lactose. So genes for that lactose will be switched on, say that here. The genes for that lactose will be switched and there is a necessity of metabolize that lactose, and that is called as the induction process. That means, in another word, in the induction process, according to the substrate, gene will be switched on. When glucose is there, gene for glucose will switch on. When lactose is there, gene for lactose will be switched on. It is called as induction, and that process is called as positive control, because the same point we will discuss in detail now, that is how the positive control will be there or how the induction is carried out in a cell. So this is about the induction definition. That means a set of genes will be switched when there is a necessity to metabolize a new substrate. That means what? If the, for example, the same definition we discuss here, for example, if the substrate is the lactose, then there will be gene for the beta galactosidase will be switched and beta galactosidase will be formed, and that beta galactosidase break down the lactose into glucose and galactose. That process is called as the induction, and it is the control of positive, or it is called as a positive control. Because for induction you can easily understand by taking the example of beta galactosidase formation for the lactose breakdown. Okay, so it is about the induction. Now here we will see that is how the operon concept was given by the scientist Jacob and Monod to explain the gene expression. So next point is that here is operon concept. Operon concept, which is given by scientist Jacob and Monod. What is operon concept? It is transcriptional control. Transcriptional control mechanism. It is transcriptional control mechanism of gene expression. Here, what they did, they first carried out the same experiment on E. coli, but before that, see that operon is a one type of a model that is called as operon model, which is given by these two scientists, Jacob and Monod. And by this model, they explain how the activity of genes can be regulated at different level, how the activity of gene can be expressed at various level. So here you should know that the operon is nothing but one of the model, and that model is proposed in the bacteria E. coli. Okay, so there will be always question asked that who proposed this operon concept. The operon concept or operon model was first proposed by the scientist Jacob and the Monod. Because in the chapter molecular basis of inheritance, there are involvement of different scientists, and all scientists are us for our need point of view. So Jacob and Monod is a scientist who gives the concept of operon, or who developed the model of the operon, and by which he explained the concept of gene expression and the regulation. See here, which this model explains which type of the regulation, that is the transcriptional control mechanism of the gene expression. Because in the first point of this lecture we have seen that how the activity of genes are regulated at different level. We have seen that it is regulated at transcriptional level, it is regulated during the processing of the transcription, it is regulated when mRNA moves from nucleus to cytoplasm, or it may be regulated at the translation level. Okay, this model explains the regulation of the gene activity at transcriptional level. At the transcriptional level, when the mRNA are formed from the DNA, at that level this activity can be regulated. So this is about the transcriptional control mechanism of gene expression, which is given by scientist Jacob and Monod to explain the regulation of the gene expression. And for his experiment, again he has taken the example of the E. coli bacteria. With the help of this E. coli bacteria, we can study very well how the operon model can work in this E. coli bacteria. So see here, we are discussing about the operon concept, which is given by Jacob and Monod for explaining the regulation of gene expression in the E. coli bacteria. Okay, so we'll see how this model work here. Then, and what the Jacob and Monod did in his operon concept. He said that in E. coli, they provide the lactose sugar. They provide the lactose, sugar. Due to which the cells of the E. coli produce B3 enzyme. Due to which E. coli cell produce 3 enzymes. And the names of these enzymes are beta galactosidase. Second enzyme is beta galactosidase permease. And third enzyme is transacetylase. Okay. So see here, this Jacobian monod induces this E. coli cell to form these 3 enzymes because they had provided the lactose sugar in the culture of the E. coli. They inserted lactose sugar in the E. coli culture. That's why that E. coli cell form the 3 enzymes, because these 3 enzymes are essential for the metabolism of the lactose sugar. And which are these 3 enzymes? Beta galactosidase enzyme, permease enzyme and transacetylase enzyme. See here, after this we have seen in this lecture, because the further point we cannot complete it in our lecture. So focus on these 3 enzymes which are essential for the metabolism of lactose: beta galactosidase, permease and transacetylase. This question is also asked that which enzymes are required for the metabolism of lactose. The role of each enzyme will be discussed in the next lecture, but before that you should know the 3 enzymes for the lactose metabolism in E. coli: beta galactosidase, permease and the transacetylase. Okay student, so up to this what we have seen, that we have started the point regulation of gene expression. In that point we have seen that the activity of the gene can be regulated at the different level. In particularly eukaryotic cell, that level we have seen, at the 4 level we can control the regulation of the gene or the activity of the gene. Then we have also seen that not every time gene activity can be on, sometimes it can be off, and the activity of the gene switch on or switch off depends on the different metabolical, physiological or the environmental condition. And that example we have seen in E. coli bacteria, that is when there is a lactose available, then and then only it can produce beta galactosidase enzyme. Otherwise it do not produce beta galactosidase enzyme. That means sometimes activities of beta galactosidase is switch on or sometimes it is switch off. Also we have seen that the genes of a cell can be expressed, and then there will be synthesis of a particular function of that gene. Gene's main functions are the polypeptide formation, protein synthesis, it acts as a unit of heredity. So these are the some of the points of the gene activity, how we can regulate it. So in today's lecture we have completed the some point of the regulation of gene expression. In the next lecture we will discuss how these Jacobian monod concept get operated, required, and how, what is the function of this beta galactosidase, permease and the transacetylase. Okay, thank you.